मार्नु पर्ने भन्ने चाहिँ एकखाले हाम्रो रगतको सोचाइ चाहिँ त्यो भएर उम्लेर चाहिँ आउँछ त्यस कारणले त्यही भनौँ र तातो रगत चाहिँ खालि शत्रु भेट्ने जान्छ
लय सिद्धि हो भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ ठुलो खुसी लाग्यो किनभने चाहिँ अब साह्रै दुःख भएको थियो अनि त्यो दुःखहरू पनि नाचगाना या त्यहाँ सबैसित बाँकी पाउँदाखेरि त्यो बिर्सियो अन्त एकदम राम्रो खुसी भयो
The conflicts of World War I and World War II were such massive conflicts and over such extended periods of time that stories not just about the Gurkhas but about a number of British regiments grew up and people had a real understanding of the sacrifices made by men in uniform. In June 1943, Britain had suffered defeat after defeat in Burma. The British forces had been fighting there for some weeks and there had been 800 casualties in the previous 8 days. The Japanese were very heavily dug in. There was an intention to have an early morning assault upon the positions, and the British needed someone to go forward to find out where those machine gun posts were. They asked for volunteers. A young Gurkha of about 22 years old stepped forward and volunteered. He asked for Hessian sacks that he could tie onto his shoes, because the British Army issue boots had nails in them that creaked as you walked, and he needed to deaden that. He crept forward in the jungle and scouted all of the Japanese machine gun posts and brought back a full report. The next day they attacked. Almost all the men were killed or seriously wounded within the first few seconds. Tuba had her pun, his sergeant and another man were the only ones left standing and they continued their advance. Those two other men were mortally wounded and he was left alone on the battlefield.
अघि चाहिँ दुश्मनसित मार्नुपर्छ दुश्मनलाई जित्नुपर्छ भन्ने त थियो तर पुलिससित लड्दा लड्दा हाम्रो मान्छे धेरै मारिदिँदाखेरि चाहिँ मलाई पनि त ठुलो जोस आयो म हाम्रो मान्छे सबै मारिसक्यो अब तँलाई पनि म मार्ने हो भनेर चाहिँ मेरो ठुलो जोस आएको थियो
He seized a brand gun and advanced alone. He's described as presenting a perfect silhouette to the Japanese machine gunners. And he advanced through a withering storm of bullets and took out three Japanese machine gun posts. In fact, he did not do it with a machine gun. He did it with his cookery knife because the machine gun was jammed.
अनि त्यो अटैकको बेलामा चाहिँ जापानीको पोस्टमा जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ उनीहरूले चाहिँ ठुलो हमला थियो उनीहरूको पोस्टमा अटैक गर्न जाँदाखेरि चाहिँ उनीको पोस्टबाट चाहिँ दुश्मन निक्लेर मलाई चाहिँ पक्रनु लायो तर मैले चाहिँ हातमा सानो खुकुरी थियो हातमा चाहिँ खुकुरी लिएर त्यससित लडाइँ गर्नु लाग्दाखेरि चाहिँ उसलाई चाहिँ खुकुरीले हानेर अनि ल चाहिँ उसलाई गिरायो त्यहाँदेखिबाट फेरि अर्को पनि निक्ले आयो त्यहाँदेखि त्यसलाई पनि हाडो खुकुरी थियो त्यसले चाहिँ हाल्यो उसको बादमा त्यो पनि झल्यो खतम भयो त्यसको बादमा फेरि अर्को पनि निक्लिएर आयो अर्को निक्लिएर आएर चाहिँ लड्दै थियो त्यसलाई पनि मैले खुकुरीले हालेर उसले चाहिँ मैले खतम पायो गर्दाखेरि तिनवटा लास्ट चाहिँ थुप्रो थियो भाइसराज भन्ने थियो उस उनले उनीको हातबाट चाहिँ दिल्लीको ठुलो परेड गरेर उसले उनको हातबाट तमा थापेको हो त्यस कारणले चाहिँ मलाई पनि धेरै खुसी लाग्यो कि मैले चाहिँ लडाइँमा चाहिँ धेरै राम्रो काम गरेछ ठुलो काम गरेछु भनेर चाहिँ म धेरै खुसी लाग्यो त्यसले
Gurkhas have a unique history within the British Army. They became part of the British Army in 1815. The British had been pushing up through India and into Nepal, seeking to dominate the region. They met the stiffest resistance from a small hill tribe in the Gorkha region.
They tried numerous times to defeat these highland warriors, and I suppose they were just very impressed by their courage in the face of, you know, near defeat. You know, these guys were wielding their cookeries against, I don't know what rifles they were using in the 1800s, but that sort of example of loyalty and bravery even transcended their enemy and enemy mentality, and they could appreciate good soldiering.
The British were so impressed by the fighting spirit of the people there that they decided that rather than to fight them, that they would bring them within the fold and ask them to join them, which they did. Ever since, Gurkhas have formed an integral part of the British Army. They have fought in every major campaign that Britain has been engaged in over the last 200 years. They have won 26 Victoria Crosses and numerous other gallantry awards. They are, in fact, the most decorated regiment in the British Army.
Majesty the King is proud to honour the heroes of the Gurkhas. The Viceroy of India has paid similar tribute to the gallantry of these warriors from the hills.
Remains an extraordinarily poor country. Prospects there are very poor. Most of them have followed their father, grandfather, and great-grandfather into the British Army. They are brought up from childhood to believe that the greatest thing that they can achieve in life is to become a part of the British Army. and to fight for Britain. And I think there's the weight of expectation and history upon them that means that when the smoke of battle comes, that they will go forward into it.
Mero Baba Pani, a British Army, Second World War Machine, Barma Lord Nuagatio.
Mero Dajubai China, Tina, Laure, Gurkha, Bada Bautio, Bada Bautin, Second World War Ma Poretio.
I have a lineage of Gurkhas in my family. My mother's father served in the Indian Gurkha army. My father's father, my paternal grandfather, served in the Indian army as well. And my father's eldest brother served in the British Gurkhas. My father obviously served in the British Gurkhas. My father's brother-in-laws, both of them served in the British Gurkhas. My uncle, my dad's youngest brother, he's serving in the Singapore Gurkha police force.
हामीले वहाँ जब भर्ती हुँदाखेरि चाहिँ हामी गल्लाबाट भर्ती हुन्थ्यौँ गाउँमा एउटा गल्ला छान्थ्यो र गल्लाबाट हामी भर्ती भयौँ र यहाँ आएपछि हामीले ट्रेनिङमा चाहिँ हामीले जस्तै के गर्नुपर्ने लडाईँमा के चाहिँ गर्नुपर्ने र कसरी चाहिँ दुश्मन मार्ने र कसरी चाहिँ आफू बच्ने
The selection process is one of the most rigorous in the world.
It's very arduous. You just have to look at the selection test. I think it's much easier becoming a lawyer than it is becoming a Gurkha. Last year, there's something like 21,000 applicants. Of that, they distilled it down to 150 or 200. Now, you know, that gives you some sort of idea of how much competition there is. So you could be, literally, you could be, you know, top 500, but you still can't get in because competition is so fierce.
These Gurkha officers know how to size up a recruit with speed and accuracy. For over 100 years, the physical standard for the Gurkha soldier has been high and exacting. Average age, 17 to 23. Average height, 5 feet 2 inches. Health, perfect. There's no questioning the spirit of these young men. They're eager and proud of the Gurkha fighting tradition.
Gurkhas are expected to serve on the front line.
अब हाम्रो चाहिँ के हुन्छ भने अब जब लडाइँमा गइसकेपछि जानु परेपछि त्यस कारणले गर्दा भर्ती हुनु नै अब कि लडाइँमा जानु हो कि मार्नु मर्नु त्यस कारणले गर्दाखेरि अगाडि जानुको लागि चाहिँ हामीलाई कुनै डर लाग्दैन किनभने हाम्रो ब्लड नै अब त्यस्तो खाले छ शत्रुलाई चाहिँ नाशै गर्ने र सेकेन्ड वर्ल्ड वार आउँदै धेरैलाई पनि त्यही खुकुरीबाट काटेर त्यही खुकुरीकै इतिहासले गर्दाखेरि गोर्खा चाहियो खुकुरी भन्ने बित्तिकै अरू आर्मीहरूलाई उनीहरूको मनमा अलिकति तहल्का मचिने अथवा नैराश्यता ल्याउने काम गराउँछ त्यो खुकुरीले चाहिँ र खुकुरी चाहिँ धेरै हामीलाई पिस्तोल राइफलभन्दा हाम्रो मुख्य हतियार चाहिँ खुकुरी हो
मैले चाहिँ हाम्रो साथी पनि भन्छ मात्रै पूर्वबाट चाहिँ अब बुलेट गोली आयो भने अब फाल्टु कुरो क्लोज क्वार्टरमा चाहिँ हामीलाई एकदम फाइदा र खुकुरी भन्ने चाहिँ हाम्रो चाहिँ एकदम भ्यालुएबल हाम्रो हतियार हो
इट्स नट नेसेसरली अ वेपन टु गन किल समवन ओर एनीथिङ इट्स अ मल्टिफङ्सनल टुल यु नो इट्स युज्ड फर एनी पर्पसेस रियली चपिङ वुड टु कटिङ अफ स्लाइसेस अफ मीट ओर व्हाटएभर
अब त्यही फोकल्यान्डमा पनि अब सेकेन्ड वर्ल्ड वारको कुराहरू सुनाएर गोर्खा आयो अब मासु खान्छ मान्छेको रगत पिउँछ भनेर चाहिँ उनीहरूले त्यस्तै प्रचार प्रसार गरेको हुनाले गर्दाखेरि नै गोर्खाहरू त्यहाँ पुग्ने बित्तिकै उसले चाहिँ हात उठाउनु परेको हो र यदि गोर्खा नपुगे भए उसले हात उठाउने थिएन लडाइँ नै गरेर नै छोड्थ्यो अब
In the Falkland War, they were shown as savages who just wanted to chop people's head off with cookeries. But again, it's not true. It's very steeped in, their cookeries are steeped in that sort of animistic bond type of religion where, you know, you respect it. Yes, it wields a lot of power. You have to respect that power and you deal everything with compassion.
Haldar Letterman VC of the 4th Battalion of the 8th Gurkha Rifles died in the capital of the nation he served and in his later years had adopted as his home. Born of a humble but noble family in the remote high hills of the Himalaya, Haldar Letterman's life's journey has brought him through immense physical, psychological, military experience of danger. His was a journey of courage of the most intense degree, established on a selfless commitment to others and the high ideals of military service and values. Letterman's exceptional deeds on that night of the 12th, 13th of May, 1945 have been published elsewhere in our regimental histories and recently in national obituaries of quality. The facts have not been or needed to be embellished. They stand bold as a report of selfless, steadfast, and undiluted ferocious courage. No quarter expected and no quarter given.
The Japanese were in full flight and were retreating down through Burma. There was great worry that Japanese might be able to regroup and possibly counterattack, so it was very important that the retreating Japanese armies be stopped in their tracks. In the engagement that Lachiman Garung was involved in, they expected a large force of Japanese coming down a jungle road. They set up a series of trenches in a arrow point formation, and at the tip of that arrow was Lachiman Garung and two others. Lachiman Garung in his youth, in his prime, was 4'11". He's a tiny man in stature, but not in his heart. The Japanese advanced in strength and began hurling grenades. The first grenade he caught and threw back. The second he caught and threw back. The third, unfortunately, bounced on the lip of the trench. He seized it, and as he made to throw it back, it went off. It took off his right arm and his right eye. It also seriously wounded the two other men in the trench who lay helpless at the bottom of that trench. I think at that point most of us would have given up, just laid down. But not a tiny Lachiman. He took up his kukri and he wedged it in the ground before him, and he said to his friends who were lying beside him that so long as I'm alive, the Japanese will not come through here. For the next 4.5 hours, he aimed, fired, and reloaded his rifle with his left hand. At the end of the battle, 83 bodies were counted in front of this trench system. 35 were in front of his trench. His only complaint when he was relieved was that when he was fighting the Japanese, because he only had one arm, he was unable to swat away the flies that were pestering his now empty right eye socket. And for that, he was awarded the Victoria Cross.
Both our nations produce good soldiers, and within the Gurkhas, they are exceptionally so. It is the warrior blood which courses through their veins. It is indeed the same blood as that of the generations of Gurkhas who have served before. That indomitable spirit of today's Gurkhas is the legacy of Haldar Letterman VC. His warrior spirit lives on in those young Gurkha soldiers who serve in our proud Gurkha regiments of today's Brigade of Gurkhas.
त्यो नाइटमेयर्स त भइ नै राख्छ किनभने त्यो आफूलाई त्यहाँको सम्झनाहरू, जुन चाहिँ त्यो बम पड्किँदाखेरि टड्याङ्ग हुँदाखेरि त्यसको सम्झनाहरू, अलि यो अरू फाल्टो बेला पनि यहाँ आकाशहरू चाहिँ थन्डर भयो भने त्यहीँ फोकलेन लडाइँकै यादहरू आउँछ, आइहाल्छ। अनि केही अलिक डराए जस्तो सपनामा पनि अब आफूलाई दुखिरहेको, अनि त्यस्तैहरू भइ नै रहेको छ, नाइटमेयर भइ नै रहेको छ।
तर म त खास अट्याकमा पुगेर चाहिँ अट्याक गरिसकेपछि फेरि कताबाट उतैबाट एउटा बम ठुलो जमिन भड्काउने बम आएछ, अन्त म खडा भएको थियो, मेरो छेउमा चाहिँ त्यो बम परेर त्यो बम फुट्दाखेरि चाहिँ त्यसको ढुङ्गा माटोले सबैले मलाई पुरिएछ। त्यहाँदेखि चाहिँ मेरो बायाँ छेरको साथीले मलाई देखेर चाहिँ हे बम परे त यही बमले पुरे होला भनेर चाहिँ उनले खन्नु लायो, भेटायो, छाम्दाखेरि चाहिँ त्यस कारणले त म हस्पिटलमा लग्यो, हस्पिटल गएपछि राम्रो भएर आयो। अब लडाइँमा गइयो गरे, अनि त्यो लडाइँको अट्याकमा चाहिँ धेरै मान्छेहरू मेरो साथीभाइ मरे, हेर्दाखेरि थुप्रो मरेको मात्रै देख्छ। अनि चाहिँ त्यतिखेर चाहिँ मेरो मन कस्तो चाहिँ हुन्थ्यो भनेपछि, अब यति धेर हाम्रो दाजुभाइ सबै मरिसक्यो, म एउटा मात्रै छ, सायद म पनि मऱ्यो भनेपछि त सकिन्छ भनेर चाहिँ हे भगवान् भनेर चाहिँ त्यति मात्रै भनेको थियो।